Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Monday, 23 July, 2012. Got a few updates for you here. First thing I want to talk about, we did not have a good weekend when it comes to alcohol. The ignorant oil was flowing and it showed. Our string of 70 days without a DUI has now come to an end. We had a DUI over the weekend. It was an E6, probably not for long, but just a reminder, you do not drive after drinking. We will catch you, and this ruined a string that we had gone. It was the longest we have gone in the last 2 years without a DUI, and now we get to start all over again. Let's see if we can make the next string without DUIs even longer than the last one. We also had a couple of drunken disorderlies. One of them resulted in an assault. The other one resulted in some property damage out in town. That's not good. That makes us look bad with the locals and gives us a bad reputation. So please, drink responsibly, and let's not have any more of these type of actions or incidents occur. This Friday is going to be a really busy day here on the installation. There's two changes of command. The hospital will be having their change of command, and additionally, the USS Blue Ridge will be having their change of command. The Blue Ridge one will be in the evening down around the pier area. You can anticipate quiet hours down there. Also, there'll probably be a little bit of a traffic flow change during the change of command itself. So just be advised and be aware that those events are going on Friday. Being the last Friday of the month, hey, that means it's giant voice testing. So at 12:01 on Friday, we will be testing the giant voice system. We'll continue to do this to get it tweaked and make it as operational as possible. So again, this Friday at 12:01 will be giant voice. Due to the rain last Friday, the Honcho patrol was rescheduled. So it's going to be this Friday on the 27th. So those who want to participate in the Honcho patrol, be down at Kearney Gate Friday night. And you can go out in town and get with local officials and walk around and help clean up Yokosuka. The 28th, this Saturday, will be the Captain's Cup paintball competition. So there's another chance to get your teams out there and participate. Last weekend was the one-pitch co-rec tournament for softball, in which CFAY won the tournament. Fitzgerald came in second, and Subgroup 7 took third place in the one-pitch tournament. Of note, though, at Subgroup 7, the mouth that cannot be ignored was not there. Lauren did not bring it on Saturday, which is probably why they only finished in third place. Noted, girl. On August 1st, we're going to institute a new policy down at the gates. This will involve the headgear. As it is now, when you come through the gates as pedestrians, we make you remove the headgear, either going off the base or coming on. What we're going to do is we're going to relax that restriction on the headgear, with the exception of the main Kearney entrance. That is the base is quarterdeck, so we want to respect the quarterdeck. You will be asked to remove covers when crossing the quarterdeck. However, at Womble Gate, at Dye Gate, and at the other pedestrian entrance down at Kearney, you'll only be asked to remove your headgear if absolutely necessary in order to get a positive ID, like if you got a hat that covers up half your face or something of that nature. One of the benefits in this is, like bicyclists, I've noticed they come through the gate with their helmets, they take the helmet off, and then when they put it back on, they fail to strap it up or something once they get on the base. So we're going to try this for a little while, see if that will work, and so you don't have to keep taking your hats off when you come on and off the installation. And that will go in effect again on August 1st. It'll start on August 1st. Energy conservation, always talking about energy conservation. Please want to keep the efforts up. It's going to start getting a lot warmer this week. They're predicting 90 degrees Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and into the foreseeable future. We've been lucky. It's been cooler than normal this year. So please do not crank up the AC units if you do not need to. Turn the lights out in rooms that you're not using. You'll see we have secured some of the street lights. The fountains, all the fountains, we're only running them periodically for PMS purposes. Make sure the water doesn't get stagnant and the pumps are still working. Otherwise, the fountains are probably going to be off most of the summer in order to try to help save a little bit of electricity. And again, a reminder, it's getting hot. We're probably going to start entering some red and black flag conditions. Make sure you hydrate if you're going to be outside. If you're subject to burning, make sure you use lots of sunscreen. We don't want any heat, stress casualties, or anything of that nature here around the installation. Those of you who are fans of baseball, the minor league team, the Yokosuka Bay Stars, have got home games this week. They're playing on Tuesday night and Wednesday night at the Yokosuka Stadium in Apama. Both those games start at 1800. Again, it's a great deal, 1,000 yen to get in. Kids 12 and under are only 300 yen. So if you want to go see a professional baseball game at the minor league level in Japan, go on out to Apama and catch the Yokosuka Bay Stars. A reminder here around the base and the installation, we don't want the potty mouse going around. We have got a general audience base. We have got lots of kids, lots of families. So please watch the language. And if you see a sailor not using the language properly, please correct them. Or not necessarily just a sailor. Sometimes I've seen some of the kids have just as foul mouths as any sailor. I mean, I know some people consider these sentence enhancers. Save the sentence enhancers for the appropriate place and time. Hey, we got 3D movie capability coming to the installation. It's not here yet, but all the theaters are going to have 3D movie capability. They'll be closed. Each theater will be closed for a couple days while they do this. The Fleet Theater, the first day we expect to have the 3D movies will be 9 August, and the 2 days prior will be closed while the installation's happening. For Benny Decker, it'll be 11 August, so it'll be closed 9 and 10 while they're putting it in. And then up at Nagishi, anticipate 17 August. Those are will have the first day where there'll be 3D movies, and it'll be closed a couple days prior to that while they do the installation. So looks like we're going to have 3D capability in all our theaters here pretty soon. So bear with us while we do the install, and then we'll start handing out the glasses and all that neat stuff. And a reminder, on the 4th of August, we've got the big Friendship Day coming up. Last year, there was over 42,000 people came to the installation for that day. We may hit 50,000 this year. About 6,000 pizzas were purchased and walked off the base, and we got plenty of boxes for to sell the pizzas that day. Don't worry. All right, on to the trivia. From my last video, I was talking about a movie made in a Japanese movie involving a sea god that was accused of making all the fishing bad. Well, that movie was Godzilla, and that was one of my favorite movies as a kid. I watched all the Godzilla movies. I even had the little model that I made and everything. I thought he was really cool. And John Kanai gave us the answer to that one, so thank you, John. John Kanai also gave us the answer to the song. The song I was looking for was Disco Duck by Rick Dees. I remember doing that, you know, quack, quack and all that, the Disco Duck. I gotta like that. And then my question was from the All-Star game was, who's the person who's hit the most home runs in All-Star games? And the answer to that was Stan Musial. Stan the Man Musial has hit 6 home runs in All-Star games. That's more than anybody else. And Brian Christensen gave us the answer to that one. So thank you, Brian. All right, I got some more trivia movies here, or some more trivia questions. For the movie, in this 1933 movie, the character Ann Darrow was literally swept off her feet. What was this movie where the character Ann Darrow was at just like swept off her feet in it? Just literally carried away. Figure out what that movie was. Hit song, here's some lyrics for you. See if you can tell me what the song is. How come you're such a fussy young man? Don't want no Captain Crunch, don't want no Raisin Bran. All right, what's the name of that song and the artist that performed it? I got a couple of sports questions here. In the first place, with the best record in the National League right now are the Washington Nationals. They weren't always the Washington Nationals. Who were they before they were the Washington Nationals? And I came up with a bonus sports question because this just happened yesterday. I was watching the San Francisco Giants play the Philadelphia Phillies, and the starting pitcher for the San Francisco Giants, Matt Cain, hit a home run. Then in the bottom of the very same inning, the starting pitcher for the Philadelphia Phillies, Cole Hamels, hit a home run. Which leads me to the question, when was the last time that both starting pitchers in a ball game hit home runs before yesterday? When was the last time that happened? All right, CFAY, as usual, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great week.